Hey YouTube, I wanted to do a little overview of the snuffs that I have, nasal snuff that is, and just go over, you know, a few of the different ways to take it and a little bit about it. I got into nasal snuff because I was a smoker for about 2 years. I was finding I was getting like sick a lot and it was kind of hard to breathe, so I was like, fuck smoking. I wanted to find a different way, so I was considering pipe smoking, and then I was like, well, smoking a pipe or a cigar, I'll have the tendency to inhale, so I really didn't want to do that. So I was like, I heard about nasal snuff, and how, you know, it doesn't have the carcinogens of smoking, obviously, and it's just nicotine, and it's tobacco. I love tobacco. The gum, I hated it, because the gum made me, like, sick to my stomach when you swallow the juice. It's fucking horrible. So nasal snuff is not only, like, have nicotine, it's so much cheaper. Nasal snuff for a gram equals a pack of cigarettes. 1 gram of nasal snuff equals a pack of cigarettes. And a pack of cigarettes is $5. At like a cheap pack of cigarettes is $5. The expensive pack will run you like $7 or $8. So, obviously the economic factor behind snuffing is way more tolerable. Snuff for a 25 gram tin, which would be equal to 25 packs of cigarettes. You can get it from anywhere from like, I don't know, maybe $7 to $10. So you do the math. You save like $120. So that's why I turn to snuff. I'll go over the few of the things I have in my snuff box here, which is an old cigar box. And we'll go from there. So I have a little hanky. They told you to buy the hanky to wipe your nose with, but I just use it as kind of like, almost like a decoration. Okay, these are the, I'll get into these a little later. I want to go over the individual snuff. Okay, so when you buy snuff, it'll come, some of them will come in like this. This says a little flip can. This is Polsch. You flip this open, and you put the snuff in your hand. This is stuff's okay. It's like, I found a lot of them, the snuffs, are like menthol, and the menthol kind of gets boring and old after a while. This is wintergreen, and as you can tell by the ice mountains, you kind of figure it'd be menthol, but it's okay. I give this 3 out of 5 stars. This is Polsch as well, this is apricot. A lot of people raved about this one was horrible, I thought. No apricot taste whatsoever. I give this one 1 out of 5 stars. I'll get the ones I hate out of the way. Coke peanut butter. Words can't even describe how much I hate this one. I hate all the Tokes I've tried. Whiskey and honey suck. Like, I don't know why, but I can just almost look at the packaging and tell it's gonna fucking suck. And I knew that shit was gonna suck. And I tried it, and everybody raved how great it was, and I wasn't happy. Now, hey, I'm up for trades. If you guys are out there anywhere and you want to trade for some of that toke, I think it's a 25 gram tin, I'll fucking trade you for something in a heartbeat. So just hit me up if you want to trade anything. Delokia chocolate, it's awesome. This is really good stuff. Low nicotine content, but really good flavor. I like Delokia stuff. Let's see. Crumbs of Comfort. This is probably my most favorite. This is a spearmint, and it's made by Wilson's of Shiro. It's from England. England has, like, the best snuffs, I think, aside from Toke. But this, Wilson's of Shiro, this is, this shit's awesome. I love this shit. This is good stuff. And what's really great about it, if you snoot some of this, and then you drink some of this, which is Dogfish Head 60-minute IPA. Dogfish Head is a local brewery here in Delaware. It will change the taste of Dogfish Head and make it taste just like chocolate. It's amazing. And that's what I found so cool about snoot. We call them snoots. Like snooting, like, and drinking different beers, like, it'll change the beer taste entirely. So, hey, get together with your boys and get a whole bunch of snoots and, like, get some beer and drink it. It'd be awesome. Crumbs of Comfort again. I would give those like 4 out of 5. I'd give the Delokia, actually I would give the Crumbs of Comfort 4.5 out of 5, the Delokia 4 out of 5. Grand Cairo, it's citrusy and I like it. I give this 4 out of 5. Now, the Freiburg and Troyer's are made by the same people that make Wilson's of Shiro. Freiburg and Troyer's was bought out by them, I guess, but they maintained their look and their recipes, maybe altered them a tad. I love the Freiburg and Troyer's because it feels like I'm going back into time with these, and they're not labeled any... Like, what really turns me off about Coke and a lot of these new ones is they say, like, honey apricot. Like, that shit just sounds gay. I want something that says Dr. J.R. Justice. Like, let me decide what the smell is. Don't tell me what the smell is. Peanut butter honey cup. No. Dr. J.R. Justice. And it's good, man. Dr. J.R. Justice is a combination of Bordeaux and Morlach. And it tastes kind of perfumey. It smells like old people, but for some reason I dig it. I guess I dig smelling old people. Old Paris. That smells like an old library with leather-bound books. And I like it. I can't describe you why I like these flavors, but I do. Nakuba. A citrusy, kind of. Okay. Then again, I like all these Freiburg and Troyer's run about a 4 out of 5. I mean, I don't think you're going to go wrong with something that's been around since 1700. I mean, it pretty much got it down to what they need to do. Morocco. Once again, something else is citrusy and a winner. You get these little, I order from Mr. Snuff, I get these little, like, packages. These are, I mean, this one tastes like baby wipes, not a huge fan. My friend loves that, though. The Cool Sparrow. This is pretty good. This will actually has a lot of nicotine. Knock you on your ass. Trying to think, what else? Here's a kind of different way. Like, you can pinch some out and snoot it like that, but I don't like the pinch method. I don't know, it's just not for me. I have like little vials here with little spoons that I've bought from MrSnuff.com, and the spoons work out okay. They deliver like a perfect little apple seed amount, and apple seed I found is a little light, especially if you're a smoker. Like, I was kind of concerned, like, how much should I take? I don't want to be like a room spinning like the first time I tried dip, but I found that if you take about a little like apple seed, so it's like relatively that much, that you won't hardly feel it at all. So you have to take a little bit more liberal amount than what they say. Especially if you're doing nicotine a lot. Don't be afraid. They say some of these have high nicotine contents. Nothing has ever ruined my day with nicotine. These are the bullets. These are what I'm a big fan of. As you can see, I have all the colors of the rainbow. I just put them in here. They're so inconspicuous. And, these things just really kick ass. Like, you load them up, they give you the perfect level of snoots, and you just put it in your nose, and bam, bam. I was doing this all day on jury duty one day, so I had to go. And nobody else could smoke, because we weren't allowed to leave the building, I guess. And I was snooting all day. I actually turned a dude onto it. I was like, hey man, you want to snoot? He was like, fuck yeah, so. Yep, another snooter. This hasn't caught on in America, and I'm like, don't know why. It seems like we're always behind the bell curve on certain shit. Like, England has it down. Congratulations, England. Once again, England is awesome, and we are gay. But, yeah, thanks, England. Because England, I found that the English snuffs are my favorite. Maybe it's the nostalgia of smoking or snuffing something from England. And thanks to all you England guys that, like, did your reviews and stuff, because I got a kick out of that shit, man. I love watching English dudes with beards and smoking pipes and doing snuff, like, tell me about the snuff. It's pretty fucking rad, man. So, yeah, anybody want to make a trade or contact me or send me a snuff to review? Because I want to review these ones. I've kind of spoiled the reviews for these, but as I get more in, I'm going to review. This is just kind of an introduction to who I am and where I started. And as I get more in, I'll review them. Put my lucky bottle cap in there. As I get more in, I'll review them, and I'll let you know which ones I like and which ones I don't. And good luck, man. Like I said, all this shit together cost me maybe $90. So, shit. How many of you have bought $90 investments that you don't never use? And this is so much more fun and entertaining, and it gets you a little bit of a buzz. So, that would be my suggestion to you. Alright guys, take it easy.